Hello everyone, I'm Kavya from class 8C and today I'm going to give a basic explanation about the chapter Pollution of Air and Water from our GS textbook. So this is the last chapter from our GS textbook. I know that we have not started the chapter yet, but I have just read the chapter 2 times and I have got an idea about this chapter and I think that I will share it with you. So friends, if you are interested, you can watch the video. So let's move to the chapter. We can survive for some time without food, but we cannot survive even for a few minutes without air. This simple fact tells us how important clean air is to us. You already know that air consists of a mixture of gases. By volume, about 78% of this mixture is nitrogen and about 21% is oxygen. Carbon dioxide, argon, methane, ozone and water vapor are also present in very small quantities. Air pollution is the contamination of air by impurities which may have a harmful impact on the living organisms and the non-living components. Pollutants are the substances which contaminate air and water. When air is contaminated by unwanted substances which have a harmful effect on both the living and the non-living, it is referred to as air pollution. The substances which contaminate the air are called air pollutants. Many respiratory problems are caused by air pollution. Carbon monoxide, nitrogen oxides, carbon dioxide, methane and sulfur dioxide are the major pollutants of air. A thick fog-like layer in the atmosphere appears especially during winters. This is smog, which is made up of smoke and fog. The smoke causes breathing difficulties such as asthma, cough and wheezing in children. Other kinds of pollutants are chlorofluorocarbons, which are used in refrigerators, air conditioners, and aerosol sprays. CFCs damage the ozone layer of the atmosphere. Over the past 2 decades, India's most famous tourist attraction, Taj Mahal, located in Agra, has become a matter of concern. Experts have warned that pollutants in air are discoloring its white marble. So it is not only living organisms that get affected by polluted air, but non-living things like buildings, monuments and statues also get affected. The trapping of radiations by the Earth's atmosphere is similar. That is why it is called the greenhouse effect. Without this process, life would not have been possible on the earth. But now it threatens life. Excess of CO2 in the air is one of the gases responsible for this effect. Area under forests is decreasing. Plants utilize CO2 from the atmosphere for photosynthesis, thereby decreasing the amount of CO2 in the air. Deforestation leads to an increase in the amount of CO2 in the air because the number of trees which consume CO2 is reduced. Human activities thus contribute to the accumulation of CO2 in the atmosphere. CO2 traps heat and does not allow it to escape into space. As a result, the average temperature of the Earth's atmosphere is gradually increasing. This is called global warming. Other gases like methane, nitrous oxide and water vapor also contribute towards this effect. Like CO2, they are also called greenhouse gases. We saw that water is becoming scarce due to increase in population, industries and agricultural activities. You have also studied how water becomes dirty after we use it for washing clothes, bathing, etc. This means that we are adding some materials to the water, which spoil its quality and change its smell and color. Whenever harmful substances such as sewage, toxic chemicals, silt, etc. get mixed with water, the water becomes polluted. The substances that pollute water are called water pollutants. Water is a precious natural resource. We must learn to conserve it. So these are some of the main points in this chapter. So that's all. Thank you.